Welcome to online lecture series Renewable Energy Sources RES. Today we will start the subject Renewable Energy Sources RES Lecture 1 Topic Introduction to the course. This is B. Ramvarprasad, Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Before entering into the subject deeply, we will discuss about course objectives and course outcomes of this course. We have 6 course objectives for this course. CO1, to study the solar radiation data, extraterrestrial data, radiation on Earth surface. CO2, to study solar thermal collectors. CO3, to study solar photovoltaic system, maximum power point technique in solar PV. CO4, to study wind energy conversion system, budge coefficient, tip speed ratio, maximum power point technique in wind. CO5, to study basic principle and working of hydro tidal power systems. CO6, to study basic principle and working of biomass, fuel cell and geothermal systems. Course outcomes. After completion of this course, student will able to understand the basic concepts of solar radiation, its data on Earth surface and different types of solar thermal collectors, design and selection of solar PV systems, and understand the concept of wind energy conversion system, and understands the concept of how water energy converted into electrical energy, and understand the concept of generation of electricity from chemical energy and extracting the electrical energy from the earth surface called geothermal sources. Syllabus for Renewable Energy Sources. Unit 1, Fundamentals of Energy System and Solar Energy. Unit 1 deals with fundamental of energy system, which includes energy conversion principle and scenario, solar radiation outside the Earth's atmosphere and solar radiation on the Earth's surface, and solar radiation data analysis and related numerical problems. Unit 2, Solar Thermal Systems. Unit 2 covers the concept of solar thermal systems. It includes performance analysis, transmissivity, absorptivity, efficiency and heat removal factor of liquid flat plate collectors and problems related to flat plate collectors. It also includes the topic of solar air heaters, concentrating collectors and solar ponds. Unit 3, Solar Photovoltaic Systems. Unit 3 gives a complete knowledge on solar photovoltaic systems, which is also known as solar PV system, which comprises of balance, and this unit deals with IV characteristics and design of system and different MPPT techniques. The MPPT techniques are known as maximum power point techniques. Unit 4, Wind Energy. Wind Energy. Unit 4 covers the concept of wind energy. It consists of wind patterns and different turbines used in wind energy conversion system, budge coefficient, efficiency and power of wind turbines, and selection of generator for wind generation, maximum power point tracking to obtain the maximum power from the wind energy. Unit 5, Hydro and Tidal Power Systems. Unit 5 understands the concepts of different hydro power systems, which comprises of working principles and classification of hydro power systems, head and flow measurements, energy equations, hydro turbines and different types of turbines used in hydro systems. It also provides the basic knowledge about kinetic energy equation of tidal and wave power generation in power systems and problems related to hydro and tidal power systems. Unit 6, Biomass, Fuel Cells and Geothermal Systems. Unit 6 deals with fuel classifications, pyrolysis, different digesters, biomass energy system and classifications, efficiency and VI characteristics of fuel cells. Also, this unit covers the classification and energy analysis of geothermal systems. Various textbooks and references for these courses are Solar Energy, Principle of Thermal Collections and Storages by S.P. Sokatame and J.K. Naik, and Book 2, Renewable Energy Sources by John Tweddle and John Ware by Taylor and Francis. And other references for these courses are Energy Scenario, Principal Technology and Impacts, John Andrew and Nikhil Jelly, Renewable Energy, edited by Godfrey Boyle, Handbook of Renewable Energy Technology, Ahmed and Joba, Renewable Energy Technology by Ramesh Kumar Narosa, Renewable Energy Technologies, A Practical Guide for Beginners by Chetnang Singh Solanki, Non-Conventional Sources by B.H. Khan. Let we have an introduction to the subject. The subject Renewable Energy Sources is a significant subject for electrical engineers. It deals with the study of different sources of energy and their effective utilization in various applications. Energy sources are classified into conventional and non-conventional sources. Generally, conventional sources includes fossil fuels such as coal, oil and natural gas, whereas non-conventional sources includes solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, ocean energy, biomass and geothermal energy. Non-conventional energy sources are also called as renewable energy sources, as they exist in nature and inexhaustible. For example, solar energy is the radiant energy obtained from the sun, and wind energy is the kinetic energy obtained in the wind. Therefore, this subject provides the information about the conversion of non-conventional energy sources into useful form, such as photovoltaic energy conversion, wind energy conversion, biomass digestion, ocean thermal energy conversion and direct energy conversion, the basic application of electrical powers. Also, the subject deals with the analysis, storage, conservation and potential of different non-conventional energy sources. In general, energy sources are classified into two types: conventional or non-renewable energy sources. Non-conventional, that is renewable energy sources. Coming to conventional or non-renewable energy sources, non-renewable energy is generated or derived from the fossil fuels. The fossil fuels are coal, wood and oil. The fossil fuel deposits can be regarded to be available in fixed quantity. The time taken for the development of energy which is obtained from the combustion of fossil fuel is approximately 600 million years. At present consumption rate, it is probable to consume Earth's entire supply of fossil fuels in less than 100 years. Coming to renewable energy, renewable energy is derived from the different sources such as sun's heat, that is solar energy, Earth's heat, that is geothermal energy, and energy in waves, which are tidal power and wind power. Different types of renewable energy sources which are discussed in our courses are solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, hydro energy, wave energy, biomass and geothermal energy. Coming to solar energy is cheap, clean and available in large quantity, which is the most important renewable energy. It gives 10,000 times more power than the required. In India, 48% of power is generated from the solar rays. The important advantages in solar energy are it does not produce waste and keep the environment clean. It requires minimum maintenance. It is reliable. It is readily available non-conventional source of energy. Coming to wind energy, in India, it is available in some parts of central India and western Rajasthan. The wind energy is clean, cheap, and exists as long as sun exists. It is permanent and inexhaustible source of fuel. It does not produce toxic wastes or greenhouse gases which contributes to global warming. It is pollution-free energy. Coming to tidal energy, mostly available in India, China, European countries, Argentina, USA, etc. It is also same, pollution free, no greenhouse gases are produced, it does not need fuel. The long stretch of coastline can protect from high strong winds. Coming to hydro energy is largely available in India, Portugal, Scotland, England, Japan, etc. Hydro energy have major advantages as it requires low operation, low maintenance cost, no fuel is needed as water is largely available in earth surface naturally. Wave energy comes under ocean thermal energy, where the energy is generated from the waves of the ocean. Coming to biomass energy, is derived from wood, animals and agricultural waste. Biomass, biogas plants are mostly found in India, China, etc. It mostly used in villages. The waste may be utilized to produce energy. The fuel used is less expensive. This energy saves firewood, leading to conservation of forest. The last topic is geothermal energy. It is obtained from the thermal energy which is stored under the earth's surface. It is available in the form of hot water or steam. It does not contribute to pollution and greenhouse effects. No fuel is needed to generate electricity. The major power stations do not occupy much space, hence there is no impact on environment. Solar energy. The major source of power which is widely used is solar energy. It is commonly used in thermal and photovoltaic conversion systems. About 178 million megawatts of solar energy is received by the earth continuously. This is 10,000 times greater than the world's requirement. The various technologies in which solar energy can be used are solar cookers, solar hot water systems, solar dryers, solar air heaters, solar desalination systems, solar batteries. Some of the solar examples with figures: solar water heater, solar cooker, and that is the diagram of a solar cell, and the application is solar lamp. Wind energy. It is second mostly effectively used renewable energies after solar energy. These are the pictures of different wind turbines. This is energy scenario in India, the total capacity and different energies used in the India. Mostly thermal energy we utilize in India. It is about 64.75%. After coming to thermal, we use hydropower. Hydropower is around 21.73% of total capacity. coming after hydro, the nuclear energy, which is 2.78%. Slowly, the usage of renewable energies are increasing day by day as per the considerations. Now, the renewable energy is 10% of total capacity. In future, the availability of sources like coal, gas, fuels, etc. will be very less. So the usage of non-conventional sources should be minimized and we should increase renewable energy sources. Advantages of renewable energy: no fuel cost, cheaper and renewable. Renewable energy sources provides energy continuously at negligible fuel cost, and hence they are cheaper source of energy, which makes them favorable over other sources of energy. Pollution free and eco friendly. These non-conventional energy sources are pollution free and hence are eco friendly. This is one of the best thing to be considered in the age of global warming. Simple design. Renewable energy sources have simple plant design and easy to operate, and no specialized workforce is required in these plants. Low maintenance cost. Being simple in design, the maintenance cost of these plants is very less, and these plants can thus produce electricity at much lower cost than the other plants. Availability at load center. These plants can be installed remotely and at location completely off-grid. Hence, better choice for simple plant usage. Disadvantages of renewable energy: reliability of supply, difficult to generate in large quantity, high capital cost, large tracts of land required, low energy density.